Good morning and welcome to Let's Talk Real Estate, presented by the Cisneros Realty Group at Keller Williams, servicing the New Hampshire Lakes and White Mountains regions. Today's show is sponsored by Blue Water Mortgage, Summit Title, and Allstate Insurance, the Joe Suazo office in Derry, New Hampshire. Time to join our host and Let's Talk Real Estate on 101.5 WEEI Sports Radio, Lakes Region.
And good Saturday morning. My name is Corina Cisneros, realtor with Keller Williams Lakes and Mountains Realty in Meredith, New Hampshire. Our show focuses on all aspects of real estate, and in the next 30 minutes, we'll share with you important information that will help you with either buying or selling your home. Today, we'll discuss water, specifically drilling for water, and if necessary, treating it for home use. In the studio today, Norm Harris, president and owner of Gilford Well, and later, Peggy Stokes, certified water specialist with Second Wind Water Systems. So let me welcome our guest, Norm Harris. Good morning, Norm. Welcome to our show.
Good morning, Corina. How are you today?
I'm doing great. You and your firm are well known in the entire region, Belknap County, Carroll County. How long have you been in business?
Well, I'm fifth generation in the drilling business myself. Gilford Well Company itself has been in, we're now in the second generation. My father started the business in 1962.
Oh my goodness, wow, that's incredible. How many wells do you drill average a year?
It can vary depending upon the economy, depending upon the weather, number of things like that, but anywhere from 100 to 200 wells a year.
Okay. Are those mostly residential wells?
Could be anything from residential to commercial to irrigation wells or landscape wells, things such as that, in order to take care of watering outside.
Okay. I've always heard this term, artesian well. What is an artesian well, and what does that compare to if there's something else different out there?
So a true artesian well is a well that has enough pressure coming up from the earth to push the water up and over the top of the wellhead. So it actually runs over the top of the wellhead itself. That is a true artesian well. There really is not that much difference between a true artesian well and a drilled well. They're basically just based upon the aquifer that the water is coming from and the pressure entering the aquifer. And that's all based upon other elevations around the area. So if you're drilling at the base of a mountain, there's a good chance that that water source could be coming from a higher level. And that's going to push that water down into the well at a higher pressure, causing the well to overflow the top of the well.
So does that mean that when you drill a well towards the top of the mountains, there's less pressure?
No, not at all. It just means basically that the water that's entering that well might be entering from a lower level and most likely won't flow over the top. But that also could be in an aquifer that's coming from Mount Washington. So until you're drilling at top of Mount Washington, that you may still get an overflowing well.
Okay, so in the Lakes region, do you know ahead of time the towns where it's hard to get water, or where the water is probably going to need treatment and the water quality is better here than there?
Yeah. So since the state has really become involved with this, the state does a really good job with their database and keeps track of a lot of geographical areas within the state. So we know where bedrock might be closest. We know where certain ledge areas are more prone to water and certain areas that are less prone to water.
When you hit ledge, is that a problem?
No, actually, the wells that we're going to be that we do are actually in ledge. We want to find ledge soon so that we can actually drill down in a ledge and find the cracks and the fractures in ledge where the water is coming from.
You're listening to Let's Talk Real Estate on WEEI 101 Sports Radio Lakes Region. We're here with Norman Harris, president and owner of Gilford Well. All right, so So somebody calls your company, and why might they need a drilled well?
So there's in New Hampshire, we have a number of homes that are still fed by dug wells, still fed by lake water or surface water systems and things such as that. So a lot of the work that we've been doing recently, especially around the lakes region, is upgrading camps and bringing camps fresh water, clean water that they can rely on that's bacteria free and make sure that they can use on it every day of life.
So back in time, was the norm having a dug well?
Yeah, that was quite a while ago. They've been drilling, you know, bedrock wells or, you know, drilled wells for, you know, quite a few years. It's not something that's was just started yesterday or something like that. So, but back that it was a very common occurrence to have a dug well because it was less expensive, easier to do. Anyone that had a backhoe or an excavator could dig a dug well and find some water sitting in the ground. However, dug wells are very susceptible to drought. So whenever we get a long period of no rain, you're going to get a well that could go dry in a dug well situation.
Okay, great. So I am a consumer, let's say, and I want to drill a well. What is the perfect scenario, the dream scenario for you to, as a driller, to get water? What's the worst case scenario?
So difficult sites I'll start with the worst. Difficult sites make it more difficult for us to get into the site, more difficult for us to find, to get the well where it needs to go to meet all state guidelines. Because now there are so many guidelines by the state as far as distance from septic systems, distance from property lines, things such as that. Access to where we need to get to nowadays is really crucial because it costs so much money to move these heavy machines into those spots.
Okay, fantastic. We're going to talk about costs in a minute. In the meantime, it's time to take a break and hear from our sponsors. But first, breaking news. You can now subscribe to the podcast of this show on iTunes and Google Play and see our show on YouTube or on our Facebook page. We'll be right back with more on Let's Talk Real Estate after this on 101.5 WEEI Sports Radio Lakes Region.
Buying and selling real estate is hard, but it doesn't have to be when you partner with an agent that has a proven track record of success. The Cisneros Realty Group at Keller Williams Lakes and Mountains Realty in Meredith helps you fulfill your homeownership dreams through a caring and trusting relationship. They provide exceptional service and advocate for your best interests. The Cisneros Realty Group is your trusted real estate advisor, creating a long-standing relationship now and in the future.
Hi, this is Corina Cisneros from Keller Williams Lakes and Mountain Realty in Meredith. For many years, clients have been putting their trust in me and my full service team. We dedicate ourselves to getting you the most for your home. Remember my name, Corina, like the song, Corina, Corina.
Turbocharge the sale of your home with the professionals at the Cisneros Realty Group, part of Keller Williams Lakes and Mountains, 66 Route 25, Meredith, New Hampshire. Experience and integrity you can trust. The Cisneros Realty Group, online at nhlakeshomes.com.
Put your trust in Blue Water Mortgage when you purchase your new home. Jonathan Ferrante works hard for you with premium service and integrity. Jonathan provides competitive rates and great loan programs to fit your needs. Purchasing, renovating, or refinancing, Jonathan can expertly guide you through the maze of options to find you the right mortgage for you. Blue Water Mortgage, your dedicated mortgage broker. NMLS number 1291. Jonathan Ferrante, NMLS number 1694126. Contact Jonathan directly at 813-267-4369.
This is Let's Talk Real Estate with Corina Cisneros on 101.5 WEEI Sports Radio Lakes Region. Once again, here's Corina.
Okay, Norman, you told us about the worst case scenario. What's a slam dunk scenario look like for you?
Well, obviously, moving in and access to the site so that we can back right in on a level lot. ledge is close. So we're drilling a water well, and we want to find ledge. The sooner we find ledge, the sooner we have the possibility of finding water. So ledge is fairly close, meaning somewhere is 40 feet or above, below Earth's surface, and drilling and then finding water quickly. A couple hundred feet, finding all kinds of water. That makes for a nice well and makes for a happy customer.
Okay. Now, I've heard of some scenarios that are a nightmare where you just keep drilling and drilling, and does that happen and then you don't find anything, or do you eventually find something?
So back in the day, 40, 50 years ago, it used to worry about finding water. Nowadays, you're going to find most people's questions are really going to be about what's the quality of my water going to be like? Not necessarily how much water am I going to find. It's what's my quality going
to
be.
So let's say you get down to 200 feet. You get some water. It's not great. So do you keep going down further to get some better quality, or that's what you're going
to
get?
Yes, we will continue on with conversations with the homeowner. We talk to them about what their needs are going to be, what they're looking for from the well to use the well for, and then we make a decision upon between us and the homeowner as to how much water is going to be suitable for their needs. The deeper the well goes, the less water you need. And that is because the well acts as a storage tank. So that storage tank becomes bigger as we drill deeper. So the bigger the storage tank, the less water we need to find in the earth in order to support the house.
All right. The question we're all asking ourselves, how much does it cost to drill for water? And I know that is not a black and white answer.
Yeah, it's really difficult to nail that on the head because we don't know how deep we're going to have to go in order to find water. We use quite a bit of data that we get from the state's database in order to determine what an average would be in your area. We then will estimate off that average in order to come up with a price that will fit your area. And based upon that, we will then design a pump system based upon what your needs are going to be to meet your needs.
Okay. Since you just talked about my next subject, pump systems, tell me about pump system technology. What's going on there?
Well, over the past 10 years, there's been a lot of improvements in the pump system technology area. Wells used to be run by pressure switches, which were when the pressure dropped down to 30 or 40 pounds, the pump would then kick on and boost the pressure back up to 60 pounds. Nowadays, we are running well pumps by variable frequency drives, or commonly called VFDs. These VFDs will keep a constant pressure in the house at all times within 3 to 5 pounds of that pressure. So it's very much when you turn on 3 or 4 faucets at once, you'll get the same pressure as you did if you had only one faucet on.
Okay. Okay. So we've talked about drilling for water. What are the other things that you do with your company to service customers around the state? Because you do function around the entire state, correct?
That's correct, yes. We go the full state of New Hampshire. As we said earlier, drilling was how the business started. In the early 70s, my dad got involved with the irrigation field also. So we have 5 aspects to our company: water well drilling, pump sales and service, which is all forms of pumps, water filtration, sales and service, and community system operation, which is community water systems that systems that might feed 100 to 200 homes. And we also take care of our irrigation systems all throughout the state.
Well, I'm certainly very impressed with everything that you do. It's an honor to have you on the show. Fifth generation, that says a lot.
Thank you.
Okay, everybody. If you would like to get a hold of Norman, you can reach him at 603-524-6343. Gilford Well Company, very well known in the area. And it's time to take a break and hear from our sponsors. But first, breaking news, you can now subscribe to the podcast of this show on iTunes and Google Play, and see our show on YouTube or on our Facebook page. We'll be right back with more Let's Talk Real Estate with Corina Cisneros after this on 101.5 WEEI Sports Radio, Lakes Region.
Let's Talk Real Estate is presented by the Cisneros Realty Group and sponsored by Blue Water Mortgage, Summit Title, and Allstate Insurance, the Joe Suazo office in Derry, New Hampshire. Let's Talk Real Estate is a production of Modern Media LLC, CRG TV, and MR Strategic Alliance LLC, all rights reserved. Join us every Saturday morning at 8:30 and Let's Talk Real Estate with Corina Cisneros, Realtor, on WEEI 101.5 Sports Radio Lakes Region.